give some high five on the pictures. So I'm gonna take a very, very short time of about 3 hours. Amen. I really feel like we could have not closed now. But I also know that you have a time to beat. We have a journey to cover. That by the end of this camp, we must have attained our goals. Amen. So I want to ask you to agree with me that we take at least another 1 hour and try to cover a very, very important milestone in our journey. Do I have your agreement? Amen. Thank you. And I'm going to ask you to go to the book of Daniel. Daniel chapter 11. And I'm going to read from verse 32. It is, if you read before, it is talking about the man of perdition, the man of rebellion who will take over the nations of the world. And how he will distort and destroy the nations. So verse 32 says, those who do wickedly against the covenant, he shall corrupt with flattery. But the people who know their God shall be strong, and they shall carry out great exploits. And those of the people who understand shall instruct many. Yet, for many days they shall fall by the sword and the flame, by captivity and plundering. And when they fall, they shall be aided with a little help. Excuse me. But many shall join with them by intrigue. And some of those of understanding shall fall to refine them, to purify them, and to make them white until the time of the end, because it is still for the appointed time. Lord, we thank you for this fire you have brought us. We thank you for the deep work you are doing in our hearts. We thank you for all those of your servants you have used to bless our lives. And we thank you for the wonderful atmosphere of your presence. Now, Father, give us the grace to receive from your Spirit, to receive understanding, revelation, and knowledge, and that we may know how to live in this evil day to the glory of your name. Father, we ask all this in Jesus' name. Come and say amen. Give a minute that is worthy of Jesus. Amen. Now I'm going to try and move very fast, so please, let's stay together, okay? The Bible here is talking about the one of the wicked one, as he will be trying to move across the world, destroying lives. And then he says that those who do wickedly against the covenant, he shall corrupt with flattery. I'm moving fast, but I want you to take note of the key points I'm bringing up. The people that are being mentioned here, who do wickedly against the covenant, are not non-believers. Because non-believers have got no covenant with God. Instead, they make covenant with death. They make covenant with evil. They make covenant with demons. But those of God make covenant with him. And the point I want you to note here is that it is a reality to which that among those people of the covenant, there are those who do wickedly against the covenant. Does that sink in? It does not follow that simply because you are in covenant with God, therefore things are moving fine. Some do wickedly against the covenant. Now, again, there are teachings telling people that once you come to the Lord, the grace covers you, and you are free to do whatever you want. Nothing you do shall hurt you. That in whatever sin you commit, the grace is sufficient. We have people in this land, and I found many in other lands, who condone the works of the flesh simply because they are in the grace. And my preachers preach that even if you commit an open sin, and the next moment Jesus comes back, you are going straight to heaven. It sounds ridiculous, but it is being preached. But the Lord is showing us here that when we do wickedly against his covenant, we make ourselves vulnerable to the evil one. The evil one gets a legal authority to touch our lives. He has a legal right to do us harm. And that is what it is saying here. Those who do wickedly against the covenant, he shall corrupt. And you know how he corrupts them? With flattery. Flattery. Okay. The flattery is someone telling you sweet things that are not true. It's okay. The Bible itself says in the book of Thessalonians chapter 5, peace, they say to my people. Where there is no peace, they have healed the wound of my people to the surface. There's a lot of that going on in the world today. Telling people it's okay, it's okay. When people are sliding down the way to hell. So those who do wickedly against the covenant, he will corrupt with flattery. But the people who know their God shall be strong. And
and then you shall work it through.
That's comforting to hear.
The people who know their God, the people who are faithful to their God, the people who seek after their God, shall be strong. They shall be strong. They shall work it through. But then the next statement is confusing. It says, and those of the people who understand, shall instruct many. Those who know their God shall instruct many. Yet, for many days they shall fall, as it were, and the flame. So what is it we're supposed to expect?
God is rich.
And the next verse goes on to say, now when they fall, they shall be aided with a little help. Now, I ask myself, if those who know their God fall, they are going to be helped by a little help. Now, who will help the people who know their God? Only their God. But then they will help them. But then why would God help them with just a little help? Are you like me? You ponder things like this. You read scriptures and ask questions. Why? I can as well retreat. If it is God who is going to help them, and it is those who understand and know Him that is going to help, And some of those who understand shall fall. Now he's telling us why. He will allow them to fall. Why? Why will allow these evils to seem to be overcoming them? He says it is to refine them and purify them and make them white until the time of the end. Now you wonder, does it take falling to be refined? I want you to keep that at the back of your mind. And I want to ask you to come with me on a journey. He can say, until the time of the end. I want to talk about the time of the end. But I want to remind you that our God is from eternity to eternity. There is no beginning to healing. There is no end to healing. So when we talk about the end, we need to ask ourselves, what kind of end are you talking about? And why? If God has no end, why are we talking about the end when we talk about God? I know everybody thinks they understand the end. But allow me to take you to the end.
Then why?
Why
was
asking myself this question.
Nobody
and the Holy Spirit brought a sense upon my heart.
Why did you take
and he said, because he is love. And love shares. In him is all fullness. In him is all goodness. In him is all perfection. All beauty. All blessedness. And God decided to make creation and to share himself with them. To share the goodness in him.
The creature I'm talking about
is called Lucifer.
He was the archangel.
He was the most beautiful creature or angel that God made.
The pipes of his music, the cymbals and the instruments of his music were created inside of him. He was full of precious stones. All kinds of precious stones were inside of him.
Now, if you know precious stones,
when you shine the light upon,
they reflect the light.
It's a mimicking of what he used to be. He was throwing off beautiful lights all over. That I can be in charge.
that he can be like the Most High.
Now,
He purposed to dethrone God.
I hope we're living together. You've got to believe. Not only should you believe that, Yes, I'm a king.
Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes, I'm a king. Yes,
The day when Jesus comes back.
and the angels will gather the nations before him. And when Jesus is talking to the nations, he divides them among sheep nations and goat nations. And he says to the goat nations, I was glad. Naked, you do not clothe me. And I was hungry, you do not feed me. And all that, as you all know. And then he said, depart from me, therefore, and go ye into the eternal fire that was prepared for Lucifer and his angels. So even the punishment has already been decided. Destruction in hell. Even Lucifer knows that it is going to end. Let me give you another scenario. If you go to court, and you stand in a court case, you are defeated. Therefore, the judge pronounces judgment over you. Maybe they say you deserve death. And you say, no, I don't accept the judgment. I don't accept that I was wrong. I want to be given a chance to prove my case. What does the court do? They refer you to the court of appeal. And the court of appeal asks, come and present your case. Bring your witnesses. Who will support your story? And this is another person for whom judgment has already been given. He will also bring his witnesses to prove his case. And after all of you have done that, after the witnesses of every side have given their evidence, judgment will be passed again. Are you with me? That is exactly what happened in heaven. Lucifer has already been judged. The angels who followed him have already been judged. But Moses does not accept God's righteous judgment. He wants to prove his case. What to do with the creatures? Don't you think he had? Come on. I believe God had a plan. When I finish creation, I'm going to enjoy my creation. I'm going to bless them like this. I'm going to do this for them. And let you prove your case. So from that moment, there came a period, I'm just going to call it an interlude.
I want you to
imagine there's a line here. And that line is the beginning of the interview. God has set another line. And he calls it the day of the Lord. From the day of the Lord, the Lamb of God for eternity is going to continue. Hallelujah. From the day of the Lord, the perfect order of God is going to continue. From the day of the Lord, the old heaven and earth will appear.
I don't want anything to happen to you.
And Lucifer comes one day, and says to the woman,
did God say,
that you will not eat of any of these fruits of the tree? And the woman says, no. He allowed us to eat of all the fruits we can eat. Except that one. We are not to eat it. We are not even touched it. For surely die. The Bible says,
Son of Adam,
you will not surely die. Are you there? What Adam and Eve experienced in the Garden of Eden
I experience every day. You experience every day. There are situations which come, and the Spirit of God reminds you of the Word of God. And another voice says, it doesn't work like that. That doesn't work. Even God knows. You can go ahead and do it. Every day it's happening. Every day. And the devil says, God loves you so much. Understand. Those who violate the covenant, he will destroy them with what? And what comes back? No, the Bible says,
Make music. shall be
judged.
Here, when our people watch British football from there, from Kampala, when Manchester United scores there, Kampala is filled with noise. They say,
But he has forgotten.
at the opposite.
When the angels are doing
it, and then you make a wrong decision.
No, 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 no.
And all the heaven goes.
Heaven
no.
Come on, say it with me. One, two.
Oh. And oh no,
is it time to go back to Tama?
Oh no,
is it time to go
back to Tama? I remember the record. Those pens waiting to see. The moment you make a decision, you write.
The
moment he has chosen us to be a witness for this
time.
And everybody says, oh no. I want you to feel it in the heart. I want you to feel that in the heart. You know, Christians nowadays, we are glad to take God with us. So,
like,
and those moments, that week will never be erased.
It's
there.
When
you accept the blood of Jesus,
sacrifice
is the only one that can be needed.
We're going to miss this morning.
If you don't deal with it, it will stay in the records until that day. At the end. To remember the Bible says, and the last of everyone will be brought forth. And everybody is going to be wondering according to what he did. Have you ever been at an election? Then they say, how do you see that picture?
On the day of the Lord.
And they are picking up records of your life. Secondly, at 2 p.m., Lucifer's. At 3 p.m., Lucifer's. At 4 p.m., Jesus. At 11, Jesus. At midnight, Lucifer's. Oh no. You will receive when the Spirit comes upon you. And then you shall be my witnesses. Witnessing for Jesus is not just telling somebody Jesus loves you. It is standing in all circumstances, in all situations, in all temptations, and in all confusing circumstances. And you obey that word who says, be still. I know that I'm
here.
Hallelujah. Give a clap to the living God. Praise the Lord. I want you to keep standing. I'm finishing. Now, brothers and sisters, the issue here, many people think about, oh, I'm serving God and doing good things for God, so God is going to be this all that to me. Oh, God loves me so much, you cannot do
live any harm. I want you to know the war is the spirit. War is not between you and the demons. It's between God and Lucifer. Between the kingdom of God and the kingdom of Satan. And there is no compromise. You're either doing it for the kingdom of God or doing it for the kingdom of God. If you say that God loves you so much, then he says in John chapter 14, verse 15, if you love me, obey my word. If you also say you love me, obey my word. He who loves me obeys my word. He who does not love me does not obey my word. And my words are not mine, they are the Father's words. I pray that the Holy Spirit will take away the pain. And you will begin to see life for what it really is. And in every situation, whether you are talking to somebody or you are silent, you will say, I am a witness for Jesus Christ. I am born to show that God is God. God is true. He's faithful. He's loving. When somebody is doing this to you, you tell him, brother, God is my provider. And he is dependable. And he is good. I am a Christian. I don't do that. Hallelujah. Don't let there be those resounding, oh no. And then they can't make a mistake and fall short of the mark. Listen in the spirit for that, oh no. And in that moment say, like David said before Nathan, I have seen that it's gone. Doesn't matter how big or how small. Break down before the Lord. Please cleanse me. Now, when you are talking about cleanse me with the blood of the Lamb. I want you to remember, it's not just your heart that you are being cleansed. It's the record in heaven. That record that talks. It speaks against you. If you don't deal with it, it will come upon that day. Hallelujah. Now, I would love to continue, and I have prepared to continue, but for the sake of time, I want to stop here. We shall pick it up tomorrow. Hallelujah. Let the clapping be to Jesus Christ. Lift your hand and your hands above your head. Clap to the Lord Jesus. Clap to the Lord Jesus. Praise the Lord. In Malachi chapter 3, it says, and those who fear the Lord talk amongst themselves. I want us to talk amongst ourselves for a moment. Turn around to one person and ask that person, say, what have you learned tonight? What have you learned? Tell him or tell her what you have learned and let them tell you. What have you learned? Worship team.
Shall be a people after the Lord.